Okay, we are now 21 days from the midterm elections. I recently sat down with the all-important independent voters. Five of the people you're about to meet voted for Donald Trump, but all of them are now very disappointed. So much so, every one of them is changing their party affiliation as a result of Donald Trump. And all of them want to send a message with their midterm vote. Here is part two of our Pulse of the People. How many of you consider the midterm vote very important? How many of you consider this a protest vote? Dale, I'll start with you.
I've been a lifelong Republican since the day I turned 18. For the first time in my life, I'm going to vote a straight Democratic ticket in midterms. Is if they're connected to Donald Trump, they are not connected to me.
So you now are no longer a Republican?
I am not, no. I've changed my registration to independent.
Because of Donald Trump?
Because of Donald Trump. It was no longer the party that I joined. It's morphed into something that's almost unrecognizable.
Stephanie, what are you wrestling with?
I feel like I'm kind of without a party.
You were a lifelong Republican.
Right.
If somebody had told you, say 15 years ago, that you are preparing to vote a straight up and down Democratic ticket in the midterms, you would have said what to them?
Oh, it's crazy.
Yeah. So why are you now doing it?
To see Republicans not stand up to him, and the ones that do are just quitting, just walking away. It's like someone in the party needs to challenge them or challenge him or find someone better, find some better options.
Nancy, how do you feel about it?
I just think there's no values left anymore. There should be values. We have no values. He doesn't have any values. I thought he had values.
What made you think that he had values when you voted for him?
He was talking about bringing America back, and I'm thinking, these are values. I thought he was more in the middle and not Republican, not to the right, and I thought the left was too far left. I wanted someone in the middle, so I thought it was going to change. No, it got worse.
Let's just make sure that we have the House as we wanted, right? So this way, at least, no major damage will be done, right? That's the short term. And I think the long term is, I think we need to come up with some solutions. I mean, let's work together.
How many of you want Democrats to take the House?
Yeah.
And
we pray that the Senate will go, too. For God's sake, they have to put an end to this mess.
Anthony, we interviewed you 11 months ago. Back then, you were on the fence about President Trump.
Try to be fair. We were at the first quarter of the game. I would always support the president, especially at the early part of the game.
And not to pour salt in a wound, but just to remind you of what you told us back then. Watch this.
We do not have a puppet in the White House anymore.
That makes your life better.
That gives me hope.
How do you feel today?
We've got a very crazy man driving the train. And he's going to kill this country.
And Anthony, are you voting a straight up and down Democratic ticket in the midterm?
Not only there, I am actually for the very first time contributing across the board, across the country. And I've never, ever written a check or spent any money on anything political because I'm afraid.
You've never given a nickel. Political contribution. You've never given a nickel for a political contribution. And now you're starting to open your checkbook.
It's a fear. Mm-hmm.
I just want to say to every American that's having trouble with this, I am sorry I voted for him. I regret it with all my heart. I feel like I've enabled this monster to destroy democracy, destroy everything that is good in this country.
You've been an independent for a long time, but now what?
No, I'm definitely voting Democrat. I've been knocking on doors. I got a clipboard.
You're even canvassing.
I am canvassing for a Democrat in Wyoming.
That's how strongly you feel.
I believe hardly anything the president says, but I do believe he's a danger to this country and to our democracy, and I'm going to fight every day. I'm going to fight every day.
I will say it's interesting because people will watch these segments and say, well, how independent were they really at the beginning? Anthony, we had on TV
a year ago,
and he not just wanted to cut the president some slack, but thought the president was out there doing the job for him, and he's changed completely.
He has changed. And so, again, some of these people were lifelong Republicans. Mm-hmm. They're changing to independent as a result of them. Some of them have been always independent or swing voters, and they're changing to Democrats. I mean, that's how strongly they feel about what they've seen over the past 2 years, and they do feel like the midterms are the most important of their lives.
It seems more of a personality thing than a policy thing to me.
Oh, it's about character. I mean, they talked about that. So some of them even agree with some of the policy issues the president has put forward, but they have all, to a person, told me that it's a character issue that is now giving them so much dismay.
Fascinating.